China's President Xi Jinping is promising to halt new coal mines abroad and says he'll increase financial support for green projects in developing countries. Professor Rana Mitter is Professor of History at Oxford University, where he's Director of the China Centre. I asked him about the significance of this speech.
This is a very significant development, and it's necessary to point out that actually China deciding that it will not be funding coal-fired, fossil fuel-driven energy outside China itself is a major step. A great many of the countries, which of course are also looking to increase economic growth in the global south, from Bangladesh to many of the countries of sub-Saharan Africa, of course need energy. But since China's become such a major investor and supplier of energy, the pledge that it will be done through green sources is a very, very important move. So this is definitely a positive. It's definitely a plus.
Fighting the pandemic, obviously a hot topic at this year's event, and President Xi's pledged 2 billion vaccine doses to the world by the end of the year. This is another substantial announcement, isn't it?
The vaccine rollout, which is going on globally, is now one in which China is heavily involved. It's worth noting that there are two main sources, you might say, of making sure that the rollout is genuinely global. COVAX, which is an international effort which is driven by a whole variety of countries, many but not all, in the global north, you might say, the Western world. And of course, China, which has also been developing its own vaccines. What's interesting is that in some countries, you see a bit of a mix match. People are actually taking some elements of the vaccines, you know, some doses from the COVAX Western-dominated brands, and some from the Chinese. And that's a sign that actually bringing a combination, bringing a hybrid of treatments, of capacity that we have around the world with the vaccine is going to be part of making sure it really does go global. In other words, we can't do it without everyone pitching in a hand.
I want to talk to you about the submarine deal between the United States, the UK and Australia, AUKUS, aimed at although it's not said, but challenging China, essentially. I wonder what kind of dynamic that creates at the United Nations General Assembly.
It's notable that actually the United Nations General Assembly speeches that have been going out so far, we've had President Biden, President Xi, a whole variety of quite important leaders, have actually genuinely been quite emollient in some ways. There seems to be an effort to talk more on all sides about where there's a possibility for coordination and cooperation. So President Biden has been talking about the need to move to much more diplomacy, away from conflict. And I think that Xi Jinping, President Xi, has been talking a great deal about where the world can find areas that it can agree on. Now, you pointed out that there is this new AUKUS deal. I think that one of the things that's important about AUKUS stands for Australia, UK, United States, and it has to do essentially with the deployment of nuclear-powered but not nuclear-armed submarines in the Western Pacific region, is that it's much more about both sides. I think there are two sides, that's fair, actually working out how they want to arrange themselves in the new order. So in a sense, it's important that a European actor, although a non-EU one, is working with a Pacific actor and an Atlantic actor to come together. And it also, I think, prompts China to think about the way in which it too needs to seek partnerships and alliances in the region.
You talk about the spirit of partnership. You're a seasoned watcher of these kind of events. Let's look at the two presidents' speeches. I mean, do you sense an effort by the two leaders to calm what are heightened tensions?
I think that there is a huge effort going on both in Washington and Beijing to try and provide some element of calm and of cooperation to some of the important issues that are going on. COP26, the major, in some ways, really very crucial climate change conference, will be taking place in the UK at Glasgow in just a few weeks' time. And one of the big questions is, first of all, everyone in the world, I think, is hoping that actually President Xi Jinping will be turning up in person in Glasgow to really make it clear that China is fully involved with this agenda. If he and President Biden were to meet there, that would be a really very important development.